Hi, this is Phil Plait, the Bad Astronomer, and you are watching Sirius Stargazing.
Welcome to Sirius Stargazing. I'm TK, and in this episode, we're going to look at the beautiful Pleiades Open Cluster, easily one of the finest things in the whole sky to see through binoculars. And in fact, many astronomers would agree that it actually looks better in binoculars than it does through a telescope, thanks to the wide field of view. In 1771, the French astronomer Charles Messier included the Pleiades cluster in the first version of his catalogue of deep sky objects, and today astronomers often refer to it as Messier 45, or M45 for short, but it's much more commonly known as the Seven Sisters. Whilst you can almost always see six or seven stars with the unaided eye, there are in fact 10 very bright named stars in the group. Asteropae is actually two stars close together, and aside from the sisters are their parents, Atlas and Pleione. Together they make a shape quite reminiscent of a Little Dipper, with the parents as the handle and the daughters as the bowl. Beyond these 10 very bright stars, there are actually over 1,000 members in the cluster, but the bright central region is easily breathtaking enough on its own. What you're seeing, like all open clusters, is actually a remnant of a stellar nursery, or a dense nebula where many stars formed close together. The brightest are all hot blue stars, and they're all less than 100 million years old. That might sound like a lot, but that's actually very young for a star. They've since blown away all the remaining gas and dust from the nebula that they formed from, but if you were to take a long exposure picture of the Pleiades, you would see nebulosity around them, and it looks like this. It appears because the cluster is passing through another nebula, and the starlight is reflected by it, causing it to glow. This is known as a reflection nebula, and in theory it is possible to see a very faint hint of this through binoculars, and a few hundred years ago astronomers reported seeing it through telescopes as small as 2 inches. Unfortunately, the increase in light pollution and dust in the atmosphere has made it virtually impossible today. And this is one of the sad reasons that we should be working to preserve the natural beauty of the night sky. At about 440 light years away, the Pleiades is easily one of the nearest star clusters, and definitely the most conspicuous in the sky. You won't have much trouble finding it. It marks the shoulder of Taurus the Bull, so use your planisphere to work out what time Taurus will be reasonably high above the horizon, and when you go out, M45 will be one of the most striking things that you'll see, even if there's a fair amount of light pollution around. Once you've got used to training your binoculars on the cluster, here are a few challenges for you. Firstly, you shouldn't have too much trouble separating the two stars that make up Asteropae. Resolving both members of a double star, or seeing two stars that appear very close together, is known as splitting. Once you've split Asteropae, try to resolve this star next to Alcyone. It's actually the brightest of several companions to the Pleiad, but it will be a challenge to see next to the brilliance of Alcyone itself. You'll have to hold your binoculars very steady, and it might help to buy a tripod adapter and attach them to a camera stand. If you can get both of those, and the conditions are really, really good, then have a look for the two dim stars right in the center of the bowl. It's a real challenge to split this double, and if you manage it with binoculars, you can be sure that you have excellent visual acuity. So, good luck. The best time to see the cluster is during the winter months, so make sure you wrap up warm if you're going out to look at it. When you are looking at it, consider that you're seeing the stars as they were before the invention of the telescope. All of modern astronomy, right up to you looking through your binoculars, has occurred since the light left those stars on their journey to your eyes. Until next time, clear skies.